This is the melody we just made. Everyone, welcome back to the Fruity Moss channel. Yeah, it's been 4 months since my previous tutorial. Now, I never planned it to be that long, but sometimes you just want to do something and it doesn't work. I've recorded many tutorials, I've deleted them all because they were just not up to standard with what I usually do, because other things basically occupied my mind, and I guess basically all of us have something similar right now. But hell, let's keep trying. Perhaps this is the one I actually finish. Well, it's 2021, best year ever. Let's do a new hardstyle melody tutorial. And now this is always fun also for me, because now I can compare actually the result of this hardstyle melody tutorial with the one from 2020. If there was one, I'm not sure. And it's always fun to see how you've changed, what you've learned. Perhaps you actually lost some skills, I don't know. Let's just get started. So, how do you start a melody? I always start with silent. Now, that's not a rule, but it's just my favorite VST, basically. Now, most people start by playing some chords and improvising some notes on top of that, quantizing it and that kind of stuff. It doesn't really matter how you start, as long as it works for you. At some point, you will know what works best for you, of course. But this time, let's start by creating some sort of bell pluck arp sound, similar to what I did in The New World. It's a track on Spotify released. For those who don't know, please check it out. I think they deserve more streams. Yeah, let's get started. So let's find a nice chord. Now, I actually cheated on this part, on just the one starting chord, because I've been playing with the keyboard for a few hours and I was like, this is a nice starting chord, and perhaps I'll actually change that again. Something like this. Now, how do we make this some sort of harp sound? We could use an arpeggiator and just make some chords and use an arpeggiator for that. Well, that's really simple. Oh, and it's really short. I actually have a lot of fun with the built-in arpeggiator of silent. Okay, we could do that. Yeah, it's just a lot of fun, but this time I just want to do it manually. Let's go down. Let's make a little bit of a dramatic harp bell. Oh, that's nice, okay. Okay, that sounds cool. Let's throw up the BPM a bit more. Let's copy this. And let's change bass lines. Going down a bit. Yeah, this is the bass line from New World, I think. Now let's fix that. Getting there, but let's change it a bit. Alright. Okay. This is a nice start. Let's change this one. Okay, let's see how that sounds. Okay, so this is a great start for a melody. It already has a little bit of rhythm. You have chord information, bass information. So it really makes it a bit easier. Now, I'm going to create my own sound for this with silent. You don't have to. I mean, there are billions of presets out there. It's just something I like to do. Doesn't really make your tracks better if you make all your sounds yourself. It might actually make it worse, but yeah, I just like doing it. They should really make some sort of link knob, linking the decay and release together, but yeah, we could do it like this. Now, to create some sort of bell sound, let's make it a sine wave. And go up a bit. Yeah. Let's copy that. Oh, wait. Let's first make it a bit more stereo. Ah, you can hear the mystery in it. That's a cool sound. Let's give it a little bit of an LFO. Changing the pitch a little. Cool. Doesn't sound bad, and there's no mixing yet, so this will sound really cool later. Now, let's for the sake of this is a lot of high, a lot of top high. Well, a lot of high. Let's add a bass to make it a bit more interesting. I think this is basically the bass line, but we'll figure out. Let's go down. And now that's the most boring bass line ever. Let's change it a bit. No, like this maybe. No, let's make it a bit faster. Okay, so if you wanna change this right here to make this one shorter, this one longer, just hold shift on the point they collide without colliding. Hold shift and just drag. Makes it really easy. Ah, okay. Wacht. Something like this, maybe. Might be a bit much, but I have learned that when you take some strange risks and do some weird shit, it actually makes it a lot of more fun to make music. Now, let's make this bass sound a bit more interesting. So I watched the Headhunter thing on Twitch, I think, and he did something. He had this really, really weird bass sound in a Soundrush remix, and I actually didn't like it that much, but there was something like guitar rig on a synth, and I was like, wow, okay, that's cool. So let's try that. Guitar, bass. So this is not a guitar yet. Let's throw it into the mixer. Let's throw on the guitar rig. Now, if you don't have guitar rig, Native Instruments, well, the complete bundles are really cool, but it's a lot of money. They actually have this free version. It's called Complete Start, or it used to be called Select, I think, but now it's Start. And yeah, there's actually a lot of free stuff in there you can use, including some guitar rig presets. So this doesn't sound like a guitar. It sounds more like when you trip over the cable and your audience really wants to leave. How the hell do we make this a guitar? Now, a guitar, compared to a synthesizer, actually has a lot of dynamics movement. So, it's not a static sound. So, let's make it move a little bit with the cutoff. Let's throw on an envelope on the cutoff. Sounds more like a bass guitar. Let's see how that sounds with the distortion. Bit better, but all right. Let's see if we go down. Okay, let's use multiple voices, because why not? It's getting messy, but it's still a nice sound. So let's copy this one and throw the second one an octave up. So it's a bit messy, but it's a nice addition. This won't be the only bass. I'm just giving it a little bit of room here, more time to re-trigger. Now let's throw in another bass to make this one a bit stronger. Okay, let's name it sub bass, because it will be the lowest bass, basically. Yeah. Okay, let's just make something like that. Now, changing the volume here won't do much, so if you want to change the volume of your guitar bass because of the guitar rig, just do it in the mixer. Okay, we're getting a bit loud here. Okay, cool. So, starting to get something. Now let's name this one Bell. Some sort of bell, I think. Let's also throw it in there. Okay, starting to sound cool. We don't even have a melody yet, but let's do some cool tricks with the bell. So how do you make this sound cool? I just like to boost some highs. And remove some lows. And the low cut basically does the most. Just hear the difference. It's way brighter now, or fresher, or colder. Now let's throw on a Valorum. I actually bought some more plugins by Valorum because they are just really great, but I'm sticking with the old one for this. Let's go to Brightroom. Let's just mess around with the settings. I actually already like this the way it is. I never really mess with these knobs here, mostly because it takes too long to realize what they actually do, and I never spend that much time getting to know these settings. But when you just stick to the left side, it's good enough. You get there. Now let's throw on a delay. I like Replica. You don't need Replica, but I have it and I like it. So delay basically does what it does. It's a delay. There's perhaps some extra features, but you'll get as far as this with Fruity Delay 2 or 3. So this was before. And this is now. That's just so much better. We could actually, to make it a bit more dramatic, I would not suggest this to do this much, but literally make it a bit out of tune. Let's track this one a bit down. This one. Now it actually doesn't match anymore with the rest of the track, but it's really subtle. So I think that's kind of cool. Okay, nice. The guitar bass, let's give it a bit more high. Yeah, it could use a bit more high. And let's remove some sub. Better. Okay, nothing fancy there. Alright, let's start making a melody. For that we can use any kind of plugin. I was actually experimenting today with making a melody completely with FL Studio stock synthesizers, but that it takes so long, I know. Woohoo! Alright, let's make a melody on this. I really don't know what kind of melody it should be. Perhaps a bit wild stylish, maybe. Alright, so what kind of melody should this be? We could go for chords, long melody. Bum, bum, da! I don't know. We could start right away. Not like that. Fits the vibe. I hate it. So if you want to use that one, it's yours. I don't know, just make up something. You can use these notes, these ghost notes. You can actually turn them on with helpers right here. Ghost channels. Oof, so empty. You can use them as a reference where you can place notes, but you don't really have to always place them on the chords, of course. Whatever sounds nice, but it's a nice guide layer. Maybe, I don't know. It's extremely simple, but it might work, because this is just the inner saw, it's not really mixed that much, just one layer. I think this can work. Alright, so let's make it a sound. It's silent. Let's name it, I don't know, lead one. And let's throw it to the mixer bus right here. Let's name it leads, because I'm not going to throw all the leads separately into the mixer. I don't like that. Not much need for it. Let's give it a lot of voices. Let's make it a 16 voice saw. Well, to make it an exact 16 voice saw, you'll have to measure the detune and stuff. I already did that, but I'm too lazy to look it up. If it sounds great, it sounds great. So, let's give it a little bit of motion here with the legato. Now, we could make it a smooth sound, or we could make it a little bit punchy. For that, I just throw down the sustain all the way and I just listen to the punch. I like that for the punch sound. So now I throw the sustain back, but not all the way. Now we have a nice punch sound. So I am going to do some legato tricks in this later, so let's prepare that. But I'm not going to do it in silent, which you can do, but yeah, so like that makes the sound less boring on the long notes. Now we could do some sort of pitch attack. Yeah, let's do that. But when we do this, it will of course have influence on the envelope we just made. But again, if it sounds good. Okay, so let's clone this lead and let's make a second sound. I know silent pretty good, so I know what will layer and what won't. And I'm sort of doing the same thing here as I usually do with the layers. That's because it really works. But I'll also show you something new in a moment. Now let's keep this the way it is and this. And let's go to one voice. And let's give it another pitch envelope. Let's use the saw. It's a bit like the lead sound of Home by Headhunters. Sometimes with just one voice I just enable the chorus. And I never really change anything. Well, to make it more extreme, you could change the depth to the dry wet. But it always sounds pretty cool. So if we match those, let's play them together. They will match. Now you can hear a little bit of low harmonics or sub harmonics, I don't know, in the sub overtones, subtones, I don't know, in this one. Some low below the note you're actually playing. We will filter that away later with a fab filter or with an EQ. Nice! Let's throw in Serum. Let's show you how to make that Headhunters our church lead or whatever. It's really easy, but if you don't know, it's a pain in the ass. So, let's show you lead number 3. Alright. Serum is a bit louder when you start it up than silent, so I will correct that now. Let's let's skip the saw. I want to modulate this pitch, the coarse pitch or whatever, with the noise right here, without hearing the noise. So I'm enabling the noise, I'm grabbing the bright white, because it's bright, it's wider than white. Yeah, and just throw the level down. Now nothing happens, because we need to send it over here. Now you can't really do that from here, I think, so let's go to the modulation matrix. I used to think of this as a really complex thing, which I never understood, but it's actually really simple. You have the source. Now the source is the white noise, noise oscillator. The destination, well, that's oscillator A, coarse, so done. The amount, how much influence it has, so that's basically it. Now, this is where I ran into some problems a year ago, and I was like, screw it, I'm using silent. Just hear it. This is actually a problem Hercules 1 has. That's why I built in the fine tune knob to correct it. But the thing is, you are actually modulating the pitch with the noise. Look at it. It only goes up. It doesn't go down. So you need to make it both ways. And now it's fine again. Now the cool thing about Serum compared to silent with the noise is that you can actually fine tune the noise. In this case the pitch is the speed. Now, another thing I found sort of tricky is how to do this pitch envelope in Serum, which is also really simple. Just copy the settings of silent. Right here, I want to have this thing in Serum. So what do? We throw everything down except the decay. Now let's do the same thing, because most synthesizers work the same. So it should be like this. When you click this, you can actually see it better. Let's go to the modulation matrix, send envelope to the coarse pitch of A. And there we have it. There you have it. Nice, right? And I'm pretty sure this will match with the rest of the sounds also. Ah, crap. It does sound a bit too high. That's... Now let's lower it a little bit. Okay, now it's time to make it a bit more interesting, because I'm taking a lot of time, I notice. But perhaps that's good. I've become a little bit slow. Chords, one. Let's do some chords. Now, let's throw this one also to the mixer and name it just chords. So, what are we going to do with the chords? Now, let's use that preset Hetman to show this, because I never really use built-in presets by Silent. Let's remember where it was. I think it's bank 10 now. In your case, it's the factory bank, but... and it's called follow. Let's disable delay and reverb. And let's throw the sound down. So, now, let's also do the same thing he did in the Twitch. I always match the melody I throw on harmonies and below them, and it basically matches the melody structure. Let's do it a little bit different now, because I think, well, it's taste, but you don't have to. And if you just make simple chords, you basically have more notes playing the melody. Now, in case you hear that, I think there are birds above my studio. Might be owls, but I'm not sure. All right, so the first thing I do, I match the bass line. So I know at least one thing is right. Let's also match these things. Okay. Now let's match the melody. Okay, cool. That's fine, because this is a seventh, I think. Yep. All right. Let's throw one up. And one down. That's where it goes wrong. This one should be up. These are very boring chords. So let's make them a bit less boring. Let's match that up with some other sounds. Now, for those who don't know, I do have a lot of presets. Of course, everyone knows by now. But if you want to check out my stuff, if you haven't checked it out yet, it's the producer bundle. Just focus on that one. It's bang for buck, really. It's amazing. And way too cheap. But hell, yeah. I just want you guys to have access to this kind of stuff if you can't make it yourself, you know. Right, so this is my little spy bank I made. I actually made a virus sound, sort of, before I actually owned the virus, which we will also use. Let's disable delay and reverb. Let's see if it matches. Nice, so now let's use the virus TI. I'm not going to use the actual virus, because it will really mess up the flow because of its own driver and stuff. So, deeper chords. These are actually virus TI sounds. I sampled them per key and it was a lot of work, but you can download this one for free. Check out the description, it's a free download and you'll have virus TI sounds who sound amazing. You can actually use in every version of FL Studio. So, it's not for contact yet, but I figured I'm doing this one for those guys who don't have a lot of money and want to have some really awesome shit, you know? Like me, because I'm also broke. Okay, now, let's play it. Here's a thing you can do with the full FL Studio version, which I really hate, is change the ADSR. Because in this case we want to have a bit more release. Okay. Oh, it sounds so nice. Just hear the difference. Only silent. Oh wait, Inspire. Damn, it sounds so smooth, you know. Okay, so let's check it out. Cool, so let's do some pads, let's do some, maybe some harmonies, and some mixing, maybe do a second part of the melody where the notes are a bit different, and let's call it a day, because I think this can sound cool. Oh, and an LFO, of course. So let's make this one. I always make the super sol lead, the LFO, of the harmony. Lead H1, it's the first harmony. Let's also do a second harmony. Now, why should we do this? Because we already have chords. Now, in this case, the chords are actually really basic. So if we do harmonies who follow the melody, but a bit higher or lower, it actually makes it a richer melody. So, I always just play one lead and the bass. So I can focus on these sounds. This is the first one, so with my logic it goes up. It's basically just correcting notes. If you do these really, really well, it will really make a big difference in your track. Now let's do the second one, and let's go down. Now, let's copy these and see if we can, because the ghost notes are enabled for every layer, so we can't really focus on what's important now. So let's copy them to a new layer and see how it sounds. Let's see. I don't know if this works, but I'm just trying stuff. Don't be afraid to try new things. So, let's check how this sounds. The main lead should still be the loudest. Right, let's throw these two in the mixer. H2, H2O. Right, so this should sound cool. Not bad. Let's throw in some pads. Yeah, for that I am definitely going to use Hercules. Let's first save it, you know. Track. Okay. Hercules 1, where are you? My son. Alright, so, factory. I never finished the factory bank. That's the same problem with Hercules 2. Because I spent so much time on making the actual thing working. Actually, last night I couldn't really sleep. So I figured out some bug fixes. Yeah. I think a lot of people have trouble sleeping right now. Analog Funeral. It's one I remade in Silent or in Serum. I think it's Serum. Wow, I just love that so much. So let's make pads. I always copy the bass for the pads because you already have the long notes. Let's not do the short ones. And let's just match these over here. Perhaps a little bit too much LFO. Let's throw down the depth a little bit. Okay, so I'm not going to name this one Patch because it's my own VST. I'm proud of the name. So let's throw it in here. Above guitar bass. Now let's drown it in reverb. I have not built a reverb yet. In Hercules 2, there's actually a delay. A really good one. A ping pong delay, stereo delay. It's really good. And the chorus. Yeah, I'm a really big fan of that 80s sound and lots of choruses there. But also a delay is actually really... if you figure out how to do that, then you're getting started on the reverb thing. But reverb is just like a lot of delays in a way. So let's throw on this one, Bright Room. Like that. Let's just play everything without the melody. Okay, let's fix Hercules. Let's remove some low, by the way. Just to make sure. We don't have to, I think, but... Alright. And let's do some sort of pitch bend attack, a long one. Haha. I like that. So let's play it again. Now it really follows the bass line, because it goes down and goes up. Let's do something about that. Let's make it go up a bit like this. Let's see how that sounds. I like that better. So let's check it out with all the other sounds. Okay, so I think we're about ready to start the mixing. And that's cool, because here's another trick. If you, well, it's not about stack the layers, really. It's more about when does it sound great without reverb and delay and stuff. Because we don't have a lot of complex mixing going on, and it already sort of sounds cool. So now, here's the thing I always do, and I still do it, because it's easy, melody bus. Everything that shares the same rhythm, I call melody bus. And I link the chords and the leads and the harmonies there. Oh, I actually didn't even EQ them. So let's do that first. Alright. I'm going to show you some new things here. This is really old. I always do this. Don't Don't cut away too much, though. Hey, beep. There's a beep in my right ear now. So, fine. Let's go to the... Wait, let's... Well, we could compress it. Let's compress it. Let's throw on a C4 stereo. It's a multiband compression by Wave. I really wanted to have the Fab Filter Pro MB, which is a really nice multiband compressor. But the C4 is way more affordable, and I really like the way it works because I just threw it on and it already sounds cool. I'm not going to change much there. So, also you can compress with Pro Q3 by using the dynamic EQing. Same thing as compression. Okay, turn up your volume. I won't screw you over, but turn up your volume and listen to this. There's a lot of low noise there, and that's mostly from Serum. Okay, so now it will be loud again. Turn your volume down. I'm not one of those assholes who just boost the volume like really loud when something happens, like some of those Minecraft channels. Okay, let's see if we actually hear the difference, because I'm currently doing this on low volume on my Yamahas. Yes, way cleaner. Now, we could throw on a CLA-3 stereo. It's basically the Tweakas compressor. Ah, it's not bad. So for the harmonies I won't do that much. I'm just going to copy the EQ like this. I'm not... that's the lazy part. Let's play it. Sounds cool. We could throw on another C4, but I'm going to switch to my Adams, my main monitors. Sounds great. A bit much attack, but might sound cool in the end. I don't know. I'm indeed with these kinds of melodies. I prefer the less attack, so less punch, but well, we started out giving the leads more punch, so will be a lot of work to fix that now. So now, I could pick a preset, but let's do it manually. Reverb, bus. Let's show you how to sidechain reverb again. So, well, let's throw on a Valhalla. Doesn't have matter what. Let's make it long, like 8 seconds. Bright room always seems to do the trick, and not too much highs. Really seems to work. It really fills up the gaps, and there's not too much reverb to hear. So let's just route it over there. The melody, so that's the chords, leads, and the harmonies. Right, and now let's sidechain it with the Fruity Limiter, because FL Studio is not your friend when you don't use the built-in compression sidechaining. God damn it, this is like the fourth train in what, 10 seconds? I live next to a railroad. Alright, so let's give it a bit of a ratio, a lot of release, no sustain here. Okay, so let's do something cool with the reverb, because now we have a separate mixer track for the reverb. I just disabled the melody bus, by the way. Let's throw up Isotope Final, which is a free plugin by Isotope, and it's really great. Let's just use the warp depth. I think this was used in Project One track, I'm not sure. It does take away some highs. It's really nice. So now let's do the delay. For that, I'll probably copy the limiter. Delay, bus. Haha, let's do it like that. Now, let's focus on the... Let's throw on the limiter there. And I'm going to use replica. Ping pong, all the way mix. Let's just hear what happens. All right, let's go to straight 1/4. Let's EQ it a bit. And actually, delay has more impact than the reverb, I think, because the reverb is really smooth, and delay, you can actually, it's really more aggressive, more rhythmical. So both of them enabled. Cool. So now we should basically be done. So let's check it out. It gets boring at the second time. So let's go to the playlist. And let's throw in pattern 1 and pattern 2. And let's do this nice new trick. Let's select both of them. Ctrl G creates a new pattern. So this is really cool. Now, I'm going to disable the delay and reverb bus, and I'm going to create a second variation. Something like this, maybe. So what we will have to do is, fix the chords. Okay, so this is impossible to do without seeing it. Hell, let's just keep the old chords and match them. Something like that. It's not perfectly matched or whatever, but now let's not forget to update all of the other layers. Okay, now the harmony should be perfectly matched, so... Something like that. Not a lot of work. Now we have a more interesting melody. Wait. The chords. We should match it with the melody right there. Okay. Oh, and the harmonies should be matched. So we still have something we didn't do, and that That's the Legato. So let's create the Fruity XI controller. Let's link the first one with the... Oh, let's disable the reverb and delay again. Let's link that one. So let's go to browse parameters. I don't know. All right. And link it to the XI controller. Now, the first one is the most important one because now we are setting up the XI controller. Let's set it all the way to, I don't know, doesn't really matter. On the long notes. Something like that. Now, the maximum is how far it goes, so how much influence is it had. How much influence is it has. So not too much. Okay, something like that. Now it's really simple. Just link all of the other ones to the XI controller. So browse parameters, this one. Only the silence have it, but I'm not going to do this in Serum or Inspire. It's not a really important, not a really big effect, but it just makes stuff less boring. I believe I can fly. And the first chords. Well, yeah, screw it. This is enough. Let's hear the leads. Nice. So this is how it sounds now. Right, let's do a little clap first. Clap 11. I'm always going for 10, right? But I'm keeping the FE. That's Fruity Mars Essentials, people. All right, let's... something like that. Bit of reverb, maybe. Follow room. All right. Okay, so this, ladies and gentlemen, is our melody for today, and it's the first tutorial I was able to finish in 4 months, so might not be the best melody ever, but I'm proud I finally achieved something again. Thank you all for watching. This is the melody we just made.